the I mean superpower of the world. You are the commander in chief.
Yeah.
Right. So you should be able to unite people of your country that you are leading.
I think he does. Are you kidding?
Are you
He's the most polarizing president in U.S. history.
Let me just say, when it comes to our military, I don't think there's any president who has expressed himself better than President Obama in terms of support of our military.
15% of the military approves of the president.
I don't,
just 15%.
Look,
I mean, you couldn't be more wrong. That number does not support that.
That's
different strategy.
Greg?
I think that the when you talk about there's always been an issue with the idea of unity. There's one side that said he's been a unifier. Other people say he's the most divisive ever. But what he really is, he's like a high school coach who's also a teacher, who has athletes in his class that he favors. Uh-huh. So the athletes who are in his class can get away with more because he's also their coach. And I think that's the problem.
Wait a second. Who are the people he's favoring?
I would say that he favors what I would consider minority, marginal classes that he thinks do not have power. He's always going to take the side of the powerless over the powerful.
As he perceives
it. Would you debate that?
I think a lot of people would debate it who say, look, Wall Street's booming.
That's a good point.
And look at the poverty rate in the country. So, I mean, there would be discussion about that. But I think that when you look at a president...
Well, he did shrink the middle class, that's for sure.
Oh, there we go. All right, there we go. So she's making the
middle
point.
Middle class is on Nutrisystem right now, right?
Oh,
all right,
my God.
Next up.